Hey, it's Kevin here. We're here at the Los Angeles Times Festival of Books, and we're talking with Drabble creator, writer, artist, Kevin Fagan. You're signing books today.
Yep.
Can you tell us what's going on here today at the LA Times Festival of Books?
The LA Times Festival of Books is just a big party that they have once a year in the springtime, and this year it's at the campus of USC. And there's a lot of authors and book distributors and just all sorts of things for the book lover.
And how's it been going today? I noticed you've had a lot of people coming, buying your books and getting autographs and stuff.
We have some books. I'm happy to sign them and draw pictures. So I've been keeping busy, so it's a lot of fun.
And now I know that Drabble's been going on since, I think, 1979, what, 34 years? How do you continually come up with ideas over that long of a period of time?
That's the challenge. You have to draw the same thing. Charles Schulz used to say, being a cartoonist, you draw the same thing every day without repeating yourself. And that's the challenge in being a cartoonist. So as long as you can keep it fresh and fun, and as long as you can draw characters that people relate to and want to see what happens to every day, then you're in good shape. But yeah, that's the trick, is the longevity.
So where do ideas come from?
Ideas come from anywhere and everywhere. You really have to be open to it and receptive to ideas, because sometimes I'll see ideas all over the place, like walking around the book festival. Other days I won't find ideas at all. And how you get in that proper frame of mind, I don't really know, but I do take a notepad around with me wherever I go, just in case inspiration strikes.
And how far in advance do you have stories written, ideas germinating, for before they're actually due?
Well, my deadline for Sunday cartoons is 2 months, 8 weeks. And my deadline for the other strips, the daily strips as they're called, the Monday through Saturday strips, is about 6 weeks ahead of time. So that's when I have to have my work in. Beyond that, I have ideas for storylines that are just in my mind, and I'm just kind of going over them and bouncing them around. And when I think they're ready to draw, then I sit down and start putting them together. But it's just a full 24-hour process, really. You're just, cartoonist is always thinking of his next idea.
Right. Now, I know Drabble is one of those institutions in comics, you know, like Peanuts, like Garfield, stuff that's been around for a long, long time. And at this point, I'm assuming that there's not a whole lot of editorial oversight. You kind of just do what you do. How do you sort of self-edit? I'm assuming that's the way it works. How do you sort of self-edit yourself and not rely on, you know, somebody else?
Well, I was told when we started many years ago that to remember a couple of things. First of all, that people are usually reading this over breakfast, so you don't want to do anything too tasteless, for one thing. The other thing, as far as I'm concerned, when I was in college, I drew college cartoons for my college newspaper. Most college cartoonists were doing political stuff. I, at that point in time, decided I would rather do something that's just funny, because I wasn't smart enough to do political stuff. And so I think that's helped me quite a bit, too, because you know, my readers come from all walks of life, and I'm not trying to push an agenda or anything like that. And beyond that, I've always felt that it's very important when you have this kind of platform, you don't want to pick on people. I mention celebrities now and then, but I never try to be mean to people or mean to occupations or anything like that. I try to find the joy and humor in life, and so that's kind of how I approach it.
Now, have there ever been ideas or stories that you were working on, that you were talking about that, were working on and moving towards, and then you realize afterwards, maybe this isn't the right topic or this is inappropriate?
All the time. Oh, yeah. I've got a closet full of strips that are half-drawn and some that are completely drawn that at the last minute I thought, nah, I don't think so. And maybe one day that would be a fun book to publish. But anyway, yeah.
And then what else is coming up? What else do you have? And you notice, the books here, the Drabble Family Christmas Tale and all that kind of stuff. More ideas for more books and stuff coming out?
Yeah, we're going to be doing a lot more books. The newest book out is Wally's Wiener for World of Christmas. In the Drabble comic strip, the character of Wally the Wiener Dog has become very popular. And so the publishers of the book asked me if I would take my two favorite subjects, which is golf and Wally the Wiener Dog, and combine them, which is almost impossible because dogs aren't allowed on a golf course. But I figured out a way to do it. So that's what this book is about. But yeah, we'll be doing more books and hopefully more speaking engagements and appearances like the Times Book Festival.
Great. Well, thanks for talking to us today.
Thank you.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right.
Thanks.